pastors that are here. I want to recognize my good friends that are here. And I also want to recognize the most beautiful girl in the whole world. That's my wife of 12 years. She's over there. I want to let you know that we are still having honeymoon. 12 years counting. Thank you so much for making it. By the power conferred on me by starting this network, I thereby call this meeting to order and to start. I'll call on my very good friend. He's a pastor, but today he's not going to function as a pastor. Aaron, to give us a little exhortation. Aaron, please, welcome to the podium.
Thank you very much. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
Good morning.
You know, sometimes when you stand behind a mic this way, you feel a bit cramped. But we'll say something anyway, anyhow. I want you to just turn to someone and smile at the person. And tell the person that there is hope for you. You are the hope of the world. I believe that this organization is a special one, and I want to thank my very dear friend and organizers of this program for putting together a program like this. I believe that this is the beginning of a great thing which is being built today. If we want to stand alone, we cannot achieve very much, but together we can achieve greatly. So I believe that it was for this purpose that we were all brought in here today. Sometimes our belief system limits us from achieving what we can achieve. That is the mindset. And to do this, I will want to give you a little story I heard that has such a tremendous impact on my life. This was a story of some monkeys that were put in a cage. And the scientist who was performing the experiment wanted to see how people behave. And so these monkeys were five that were put in a cage, and in the cage they put in a ladder, and on top of the ladder was banana. You know, monkeys and bananas are very good friends, you know that? So what he did was, one of them saw the banana and said, "Oh my, this is my favorite, I'm going for it." So he attempted going for it, and then they sprayed that monkey and all the others in the cage. So what is wrong here? What is wrong with taking bananas? The second person tried, everybody was sprayed. Then they went like, there must be something wrong with this banana. So the scientist continued with the experiment. All five of them tried it and they were all sprayed. So now the scientist took one out, brought a fresh monkey, so there were four old ones and one new one. This new one did not know anything. But now, those other monkeys in the cage were afraid to go for the banana, because if you take banana, you'll be sprayed. This new monkey came and said, "What? You are here and there is banana on top of this ladder and you will take it. I'm going for it." So he attempted going, he was sprayed, the others were also sprayed. So the next one came, who they took another one out, brought a new one in. And this time, when this one came and saw it and wanted to attempt taking it, the others pulled him down and beat the hell out of this monkey. They took another one out, brought a new one, same thing. That one was also beaten. Until it got to a point, all the old ones who had actually suffered spraying were taken out and fresh ones came in. Guess what? A new one was brought in, attempted to take it. Those ones who have never been sprayed, because it was a pattern, pulled the person down and beat that the hell out of the monkey. And this is how sometimes we think. We come, some of us have traveled from other countries and we are here, there are opportunities, but there is a mindset. Here, you don't go beyond this level. This is where you have been placed. This is the limit. You only have to work in the warehouse or the corporate level. Let them pay you. You have your nice car, you have your nice whatever. What is wrong getting that? It is nice. Everybody at home knows you are doing great. That is enough. But we have to break out of the limitation. If you want something, it's not enough just wanting. You have to hunger for it. And if you want to shoot for the moon, go for it, because even if you miss it, you will land among the stars. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you very much. You will land among the stars. Because it's a network meeting, I want to seek your opinions, please. Let's stand up, let's go around. Mr. Shaleh, talk to somebody you've seen for the first time. Please, introduce yourself to that person. Now you do your own introduction. Do your own introduction. Go around, meet somebody, talk to that person, him or her, your name, what you do. Please make sure you are talking.
How are you?
Phillips. Okay, yeah, you're going to come to my daughter's school now.
I just
it's supposed to be here this morning, but they
come in. Oh, it's not. Yeah, it's
supposed
to be. Make sure you are talking, make sure you are moving around.
You see, I see just greatness in my brothers, and I'm honored to know you. This is my car. I work for my coach. Nice to meet you.
Hello, sir. Nice to good morning, sir. My name is Aaron.
So maybe we'll talk some more.
Okay.
I think we are meeting for the second time, right?
I will say third time.
Good to see you. The Lord is blessed.
I've been looking forward to meeting you for a long time.
Saturday. So the service provided monthly network meeting like what we're having right now, training, seminar, workshop, trade fair and exhibition. It will be once in a year or once in 2 years. You can start that. Pitch your services good to investors. Do we have anybody watching Shark Tank here? This will be a replica of Shark Tank. Yes, we bring investors and we let people pitch their goods and services, and if the investors like it, they will invest in them. We want to break every barrier, because not everybody can go to Shark Tanks, but we can have our own Shark Tank here in Columbus, Ohio.
Yes.
Breaking barriers, let people have the opportunity. That's the purpose. Then business information and resources.
Me and Pastor Sonia, we talk a lot. We share a lot of things. I will call upon him to share some duties. Oh, he's outside now. Sometimes when we speak up the phone to talk, we might talk for hours on the phone, just sharing different ideas, different strategies. Sometimes things that might cost me money, but after we finish talking, we find out that I don't have to spend the money. So we've been doing that. And also, loan packaging. We've been liaising with all the companies to do loan packaging. Certification assistance, that is through our affiliations. The legal and big marketing services, accounting services, procurement and building assistance, e-commerce and business, and website design. We've been liaising with professionals to make sure that these are reached to the people so that all this opportunity they can take advantage of at a minimal rate, not at the market rate. Affiliations, we are directly or indirectly associated with the following association: U.S. Small Scale Business Association, Ohio Small Business Development Center, Maylin, am I right?
Maylin.
Yeah, I'm late. Okay then. So she's a representative of Ohio Small Business Development Center. Thanks so much for coming. I can never thank you enough. Central Ohio Minority Business Association, I told us earlier, the president have accepted to be our guest speaker during the next meeting. African Diaspora Organization, we are directly or indirectly involved with them. International Training Institute, we have. I want us to take advantage of all this. I will be reaching out to you. I can never thank you enough. Somebody walked in when I was having my speech. I've known that directly over close to 20, directly and indirectly, close to 20 years when I was doing my youth service. Youth services, she was my boss indirectly. Youth service is a compulsory, something you have to do from the country I came from. Just like people going to do, what is it? Is it military training? Yes, yes, you have to serve the government for at least 1 year. So I want to call her, I want to call on her to introduce herself. Pimpi, Isola. Please, Mark, can you stand up and introduce yourself?
You already introduced.
We want to know what you do, what you what.
Okay, my name is Pimpi Isola. I'm a pastor, I'm a pastor's wife. I am into ministry work, leadership development, and training. I'm a life coach. I'm a wife, I'm a mother of 4 children. I don't know what else you want to say.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, join me to welcome to the podium Kate to introduce our guest speaker. Let's give her a round of applause.
Good morning. One of the first things that I want to say today is to exhort and encourage you. I don't know if any of you have ever seen the program called American Ninja Warrior.
Yeah.
Have you seen that?
Yeah.
I'm addicted. I love it. And I think I love it so much is because it demonstrates the strength of human determination and the sacrificing that it takes to get where you want to go. But the most important thing I want to bring up to you today about that, and that's on Monday nights on NBC, if you ever want to watch it and encourage yourselves. The thing I want to bring up is that none of those competitors compete with one another. They compete with the obstacle. They compete not trying to be better than. They want to do their very best to get to their goal in a record amount of time so they can move on to the next obstacle that they have to overcome. When there are other ninja warriors who have gone further or who have gone, because this is 7 years now this program is going, they're on the sidelines encouraging and calling to them, don't forget to breathe. grab a hold, get tight, because they want the other to succeed. I want to encourage you. It doesn't matter how many life coaches are in the room. It doesn't matter how many pastors are in the room. We are not each other's competition. It's the obstacle to get to our goal that is the competition. So I encourage you to encourage one another. Help to resource to one another. If you know somebody you're talking to that could help somebody that you just met, take the information and empower them so that they can overcome the obstacle. Don't ever allow your heart or your frustration to try and compete against your brother or your sister who is also running the course. Such a person who's been brought up and lifted up like each of you to run a course, to run it in record time and bring people with her to do the same, who has been involved in not only the Latino community, but with women in general. She's young, she's vibrant, and she is a symbol that the Lord is raising up new thing. You're doing networking now. It's a new thing. I just want to introduce Mei-Ling. She has told you a little bit about herself. She will tell you more about herself. She has a lot of valuable information to help you run that really difficult obstacle course. And that if you fall down or you get knocked down off the course, she'll show you how to get back up. Really.
That girl is just talking about. Wow! I like her. Can you guys hear me okay?
Yeah.
So, thank you. She moves. Okay. So, good morning and welcome. Again, my name is Mylene Samboys Sanchez. I just got married 2 months ago and I'm still in a honeymoon in Ontario. So, I pray that after 12 years also I can be the honeymoon in Ontario. So, God just showed me it's definitely possible. So I'm going to give a little bit of information about myself so you know who I am and why we're here. So I was born in the Dominican Republic. I came to the United States when I was 12. I really thought I was going to Disney World because that's what I thought Disney was in New York, right? Not the case. So it was a very different abrupt experience to think you're going to meet Mickey Mouse, but you actually meet the projects in the Bronx. Very different. But then at that time, I learned early, you can have a decision, right? You could be like totally upset. I am not in Disney, where is Mickey? Or, okay, we're here now, how can we make this work? Which is really what my family had to do. We left our homes, we saw our houses, we did a lot of things. And we did all that because of a hope that over the sea, this would be a better place for us, right? That you will leave your family and everything that you so love dearly so you can make a better life for your children. So many of you may be here because of that same thing. I went through it. And through me, the driving force to do better was that my parents sacrificed their life and their family for us to do better, so I had to do better. So I was in New York for a couple of years. I came to Ohio, did high school. I learned English in Ohio. I never thought it could happen, but based on what I'm doing so far, so good. Then I went to New York and did college. I have a psychology major and a business administration minor. I'm bilingual, I speak Spanish and English. I wish I could learn more. I speak a little bit of Arabic, not a lot. I took it in college, just enough. And you know, like everybody else here, I had my trials. I was married before, I divorced. I was married for 6 years. That did not work out, but I had a plan. I'm remarried. I have two beautiful stepchildren. They're amazing. And my husband now has the same purpose that I have. He motivates, he empowers, and he helps children and the youth to know that no matter what happened in the past, from this moment on, you can have a life. From this moment on, today, you woke up, you're breathing, God gave you another chance, then make your life better starting right now. What you did in the past doesn't matter. It doesn't really matter because there's nothing you can do about it. From this moment, you have another chance to do better. So when I learned and I met him and he did that, I'm like, this is the man for me because that's my beliefs. Those are my values. and we're here to make the world a better place. Every person that we meet, we want to make sure they move better than how we found them. So that's how you know if you're looking for a partner, keep that in the back of your head of what you should be looking for, right? So then I worked for Chase. So before Chase, I was in college in New York, and Geico, an insurance company, they came to my school and they hired me, like right before I graduated. I thought it was an interview practice. It was a real interview, and I had a job before I graduated. I was blessed with that. So I was a manager for sales and customer service. I didn't think I could sell based on their criteria. I did. So I had those high positions, and I learned a lot. I did Toastmasters. I learned how to handle very escalated issues, so psychology really helped. And then I came to Ohio for a wedding, and they told me, this has been my life. So when somebody tells me you can do something, I must prove them wrong, because you just dare me. So I was told that Chase was very difficult to get into, that they're a company very picky. So I came to my best friend's wedding, and I said, I'll apply and see what happens. I applied, I got a job offer at that interview, and I had to move in 2 weeks to start a new job. So I started Chase. So I was in New York a manager. I came to Ohio as a rep. Now you must understand, when you let your ego get on the way of your path, you're not gonna be successful. So don't think about titles. Titles don't make who you are. They don't make you to be the person. The title, you respect the title, but do your job, right? So I accepted. The managers couldn't believe it, that I was gonna take this half pay cut. Living expenses in Ohio are cheaper, right?
Yes.
But that I didn't want to be a manager of a group of people, but I didn't know their job. I didn't want to be like, well, tell me how to do this. I should know that. So that was a personal preference. I'm not saying you should do it, but that was how I operated. So I took the job, and because I was humble, right, not to brag, well, I don't want to do that because I was a manager. Nobody was allowed to know my previous jobs because I didn't want that. I want them to see me as a person just like them. Let me learn with you, because we were a class of bilinguals that came in. Chase actually stopped outsourcing things and brought the operations to Ohio. So I was going to be part of that team. So I learned with them. I failed with them, and we grew together. So within 6 months, Chase wanted to promote me. I wasn't trying to get a promotion. I just wanted to do my job. That I want to promote you to be an assistant manager, because I was already helping my supervisor out of the kindness of my heart, because I wanted her to be successful, because I was in that position, right? So they promoted me to assistant manager, then they wanted to be a supervisor after 6 months, that we'd be ready to be a manager. I'm like, well, okay, so now let me explain this to you. You need to know your worth. As a business owner, or as a person, your worth is only something that you can determine. Nobody else can determine your worth. So when you're gonna go for a job or your own business and you determine your prices, you must know your worth. Now we're like priceless, like I like to say, right? But you must put a worth to that, right? So when Chase offered me the supervisor position, I'm only sharing this with you because I want you to know my experience, and it may not be yours, but it could help somebody else. So through that experience, I helped a lot of people after that at Chase. So they offered me the same job, maybe like $1,000 more, to take like 3 times more work. Which is now I'm responsible for the emotional responsibility of people. I have to fire and hire people. So I was already coaching, I was already helping people, I was kind of helping with interviews, but at this time that was going to be my responsibility. And God knows the long hours, no, right, no overtime, it was salary, so you know as you're going into that position what your duties are going to be, and going to be more than that. So I didn't want to take it because I was happy where I was happy with my responsibilities and my paycheck and the less headaches. So now for that little bit amount of money. So I told them, you can give that to somebody else that's ready to take that for that amount. I'm happy where I am. They did not like that. They were not ready for me to tell them that. So I waited patiently, and they came back. The people they were trying to get were not the right fit. So they came back to me, and they gave me what I wanted. So I was able to double my salary and go back to where God had taken me from, and he brought me back with patience and trusting him. And he was going to do the right thing for me, right? So then, and within a year, I was already double my salary. I was back to being a manager, which I didn't plan to. And I was very happy. So because of my work ethic and just what I love helping people, Chase actually sent me to Argentina for 3 months. So I learned a lot. I opened a call center there. I trained agents in service, because there's something that you can train in service, self-skills. And you will do this in your businesses. Your business could be the best business in the world, but if you don't have good customer service and you don't care about your customers, your business would never take off.
Right.
Because they would never refer you, right? So I was sent out to Argentina, because I was bilingual, to open a center to explain this community the differences of sarcasm, which over there they didn't understand, right? So I had to explain sarcasm. So when people say, I'm happy with you, they're not happy with you, they're upset with you. So kind of those little tones and things. So I opened a center in Argentina, I opened a center in Canada. And then I came, so I was going for a couple months out of the year. Then I came home and I said, you know, I have mastered my position. One thing I learned, and I think I love this about each one of you, is when you know something, sharing is caring, don't keep it. You're not gonna say, you're gonna take it to the grave, you gotta share it. If you learn something, if there's an opportunity, share it. So my desire was, like my dad and his business, anybody under me, because I had a lot of agents, at one point 30, I had to have at least 5 people that always knew my job. I was never threatened that they could take my job. I wanted them to, because that means I was ready to move on to the next level. Right. So I trained them, so when I was on vacation, I was in work assignments, they could do my job, sometimes even better than me. That was a compliment. I helped them that. So many of my agents were actually able to go to be supervisors. Never a threat. I see people as an opportunity. And I learned a lot from them too. So then, because I was able to train them, they were able to actually take my position. I was able to move through Chase. So after 2.5 years of being a manager, I moved into like IT, a little bit of IT. So I managed call centers all over the world. We have centers in Manila. We have centers in Monroe, Canada, Argentina, and Easton and Polaris. So I was working the night shift. Now mind you, it was 8 to 5. I'm gonna go to 3 midnight because I wanted to learn something new. So I was able to manage all the call centers when we had disasters, all of that, learn a lot. I learned it and I'm like, okay, I already know this. I'm not challenged. So when I'm not challenged, I like to move forward. So that's my thing. So then I'm like, somebody's ready to take my job. I can go to the next thing. Then I went back to be a manager for a whole different department. I was in service first, then I was in call routing, and then I went to originations. I wanted to learn how the loans got started, because I was dealing with all the problems after. I needed to learn how did this happen. So I did that for 2 years, and then I learned it. I trained people, they're ready to take my job. I went to IT. I was told IT was hard for women. I said, I could do it. Never, no background in IT or computers, remember psychology. So, excuse me, I was able to do it. I was a business analyst. I was the liaison between the developers and the customer service. So you will come to me and say, I want this new system to help my customers. I'll talk to the developers to make sure that you got what you requested. I thought it was pretty easy. I wasn't developing, I was in IT. So I did that for a year. I said, yeah, you know, I don't like that because there's no face connection. It's a lot of phones, a lot of meetings. People are very cutthroat, and that's not my personality. I like this, I proved that I can do it, I'm ready to move on. And thank God opened this position where I am now. So I knew about this department, the Small Business Development Center has helped my family open businesses in the past. They are in the community and they help everyone. We're an international, good morning. Great, we're an international organization, so we actually are all over the United States and we're also in Puerto Rico. I'm hoping to go to Puerto Rico one day, that's my hope. With them, paid for, because I've been there on my own. So then when this opportunity came through, I didn't jump on it right away. I found it very interesting that God has placed a position that had everything I was already doing in the community. I wasn't getting paid for it. I was already helping people start business. I was coaching people unofficially. I was doing everything this position was outlawed for me to do. I read it and I said, if you want me to go there, I will apply, I go. I applied for the position. I got an email telling me like 2 months later the position was given to somebody else. And I was like, that's fine, it's not the right time. But a little voice, I thought it was crazy for a moment. It said, don't worry, they'll call you. I'm like, that is crazy. They just told me, I'm reading an email that says you have not been selected. But the voice says, don't worry about it, they'll call you. I went on a cruise, I came back, I got a call from the office. Are you still interested? We want you to take this job. What? Right? The magic of when something is for you is for you. So, hi.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Please, if you need anything, because they are about to shut down the break, they'll be going around to ask you before they close the breakfast. Please, if you need anything, please let them be away, okay?
You have beautiful girls asking you for something else. All right. You can write your order on a piece of paper and give it to them. They'll take care of that for you. So in addition to that, so when I applied for the position, I started on May 1st of 2014. So I just been in this position for a year and 2 months. And I can tell you how many people like us have ideas. They're working for a corporation that they've been very loyal to for years. And then one day that corporation no longer needs you and they let you go. So mind you, you've been loyal to them, but they're not loyal to you. Sometimes you have very difficult managers and you just can't do it anymore. So a lot of people are like, I'm ready to leave and start my own thing. So I get a lot of those kind of clients. I get clients that are in school, or they came from another country, and they were like doctors in their country, or they did something really great in their country, and they are working in a position that is not equals to what their worth and what their values are, but they know they have to pay the bills. But that's not it. Some of them know, and I think I find this a lot with our minority clients and our foreigner clients, that we know that we're meant for greatness. And this is just a stepping stone. So I don't care if you're cleaning, if you're cooking, if you're serving, whatever you do, do it with joy, because life is very short. But if you want to, if you're happy with that, by all means, do it for life. And what you're doing is what you love, continue to do that. But if it's not what you love, then you have to ask yourself, what do I love? Because the money will come. I tell my clients, don't come to me with the idea I want to make $1 million, but I hate doing this, because I can't help you. The energy is not right. What you're thinking in your heart is very different than what you're thinking here, and it can't work. So you have to love what you do. And then I can help you about getting the money, right? So if you go with the right idea, then we start a plan. My husband is the one that's like, leave before you think. And I'm like, no. So I'm in his presentation, stopping the people from quitting their jobs. Don't quit your job until we have a plan, right? And you'll be tested. Once God has put the fire, I hope I'm not offending anybody by saying God here, right? Once God has put the fire in your heart that there is something else you must be doing, that there is greatness within you, and that the 9-to-5 is not your thing. I don't care how much money they give you at your job. I worked for Chase for 8 years. No matter how much vacation time you have, you have a lot. No matter what bonuses and perks you get, that fire will not allow you to be comfortable. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Right? If you ever felt that, then you know what I'm talking about. Now, I try to fight it. I did. I said, I just want to be normal. Why didn't you make me the 9-to-5 girl? Just want to have a family. And just that's it. And to be honest, a strong voice to me, that's not what I made you for. Right? So that's not what he made me for. There's people that are happy with a 9-to-5. There are people that are happy with not working. Right? There are people that will never be in this, because this is not their thing. But we're excited, we're happy, we're thankful, we're smiling, we're meeting new people, we're here to help each other grow. So whatever your passion, whatever your love is, if you're doing something that you don't love, take the time to figure out what it is that you love. And then we can make a plan to transition. Either if you're in a corporation, or you're maybe doing a business that you don't like. Maybe you're doing insurance, but you want to do photography. But let's talk about that, right? Let's create a plan. I believe in creating a plan. A book that I read is a very good, great book, because we have a lot of ideas. We want to do everything. You have to do one thing at a time. And there's the book, it's called The One Thing. If you never read it, I recommend it. It was the first book my husband and I as friends read. And it's called The One Thing by Gary Keller. He's the founder of Keller Williams Realty. I think he's doing pretty well, so I will read his book. And it was very helpful, because it kind of narrows down all these ideas into one thing. Right? So think about that as you go through your thing. So that was my position. By coming to the Small Business Development Center, I was hired to make sure that Latinos and minorities knew that there are services out there for them to help them to start their business right. But if you already started your business and you're struggling and you have some obstacles, then come to us and we can help you overcome those obstacles. Life is not over. I love to meet people before they go to a point where it's too hard to get funding or to, you know, move forward. If you come to me earlier, we can definitely avoid a lot of things, right? So we're like, well, do you have a business? I do. I have two. So I have a 404 Latinas as a company that works with women and girls in the community. We do leadership components, workshops. And then I have Femergy, which is a nonprofit company that works with girls and women in the community. And we actually, we didn't want to be a nonprofit. We really didn't, to be honest. We wanted to be a for-profit company, but we were doing a lot of nonprofit work. And we were funding the company for 2 years. So the IRS was like, are you a hobby? Or are you a nonprofit? Because you're not making any money, but you're helping all these people. So with the right guidance, we decided to go nonprofit. So now we've been in business for 2 years. We've been blessed. And we're growing. We're learning a lot. So with somebody, now this is the thing. Let's say you have a nonprofit. You have a business. But I see in the community a lot of times people want to hug that information, like, no, I can't share that with you, because then you will be good like me. So we're very different. We have to struggle with being a nonprofit because we don't know. It took us a year to get this process down. So God bless us. And sending me one of my best friends now is actually an auditor for the IRS. And she took it upon herself to help us with the process. And we were blessed. In 2 months, we had something that took us a year to get to. So now when you come to me and you say, I want to do a nonprofit, guess who I call my best friend? I said, you need to come and meet my client. I need them to have the right resources. I need them to get it right. And the fastest nonprofit that we just funded, we started, was like in probably 2 weeks. So I was able to meet with her and this client of mine. And we went through the process. We answered his questions, even on the weekends. And he applied and he got a response in 2 weeks. That's the fastest I've seen a nonprofit get approved. But that's because I knew I was able to share and I want him to be successful, right? So like what you were saying, I agree with that. We're not competing with each other. We're competing with our own selves. Number one, you gotta be better than yourself. I'm not trying to be better than any of you. You guys are all different, and thank God, because it will be very boring, right? But I wanna be better than myself every day. And if there's an obstacle, we need to overcome it together. Together, we're so strong. When I show my husband this, he almost flipped out because he couldn't be here today. But this is such an amazing thing that we are all coming together, very international, and we're coming for the same cause, to be better and to help each other. So you talk about life coaches, my dream, which I do unofficially, but I like to get certified for that, right? But you can get a contract, and I think when I read the reviews here and the things that you guys offer as a service, that's something that you can be certified as a minority business. And then you can get a contract. So all of you can apply for a contract, and then it's good because one of you will get it. I mean, the odds, right? There's so many of us applying for one contract, one of us has to get it, right? And if you get it, then you cannot do the $3 million contract by yourself. That's insane. You have to get a team of people that you trust, and you are building a team right here. So when somebody catches that big fish, there's enough for everybody to eat. So I need you, when you leave here, if you think of anything I left you, think of that. I'm gonna go after what I want, and I wanna help those with me. It's not just yours, it's a lot of money out there. And the mentality has been, let's make us go against each other. So then we don't grow, we don't flourish, and then that little group that's together, they get all the money, right? So how do you change that mindset? You become the best person, the best business you can possibly be and have. But then be open to share where the opportunity lies. I'm not an accountant. God knows I can get accounting in college. I'm not a lawyer. I can argue like one, but I'm not a lawyer. But I have enough contacts. I don't do insurance anymore, I'm not licensed. But if I need an insurance advice, I have people in my network, I just met you, right? If I need a life coach, I'm not certified, I got you, right? If I need to bring a woman to speak to my event, I have, you know, so you have to think about in the room, when you all speak, and I took notes. Because each one of you has something that you can contribute to what I do on my business. My day job is connecting people. I'm a hub. I connect people. Right? I cannot do it all, but I have an amazing team that I create every day that can help me help my clients be better. So I just want you to keep that as we continue this conversation. And if I lose you, let me know. I speak fast. I'm Dominican. So some of the things that you guys picked up in the beginning, I hope you have them all, right? So if you don't, we can give that to you later. That's no problem. I wanted to give you a quick overview of what my position and my job do, right? So right here, this pamphlet, I'm short, so hopefully you can see it all back up here. This pamphlet, if you don't have it, then share with your neighbor. It's time to start sharing. I have some more in my bag. So this is a small overview of what the Small Business Development Centers do all over Central Ohio, right? If you go all the way to the last part of the pamphlet, you will see the services that we offer. So if we don't have this service in-house, we have a team of pro volunteers. It's called the PROS program. And all of you actually can participate in that. So let me explain to you how that works. You have a profession or skill that you're great at. And you're a professional at that. A pro, we call you. Then what we do is I will have you in a database. And I have to send you an application process. They say that you accept it and you become a pro volunteer. That means that if I have a client that has, you know, they're going through something really hard, they need guidance. So you volunteer 1 hour a month of your time to be with that client or a group of people. And then after that, if the client needs your services, that if you did your job right, they love you, they want to work with you again, then you charge for that extra services. But we make that lead connection. When you have to go purchase leads, we're giving you a lead. That's pretty much what it is, right? And in return, our clients that don't have so much money to begin with can have that experience and that assistance. Does that make sense? So I'll give you an example. I do a class once a month. I do a Latino class for how to start your business. It's a 3-hour class, so I'm not gonna do that to you today. And then I do the same thing in English, but the English one is broken down in 3 parts. So we have every Tuesday, I'm gonna go out and talk about that, but there's 3 Tuesdays of every month where we provide a series on how to start your business. Even if you have your business, I encourage you to come, and I'm gonna tell you why. There's 50 people in that class, and it's a waiting list every month. It gets full every month, and it's a free class. So you come in, you introduce yourself like we did today, you're gonna meet 50 different people. Someone in that room is gonna need your business. And you may need the business of somebody there. So that's one of the first reasons that I would say why I encourage you to attend. The second reason is the knowledge you're going to obtain. You're always gonna learn something new. So the first class is the general information. You wanna start your business? Great. These are the things you should think about. The second class, we bring a lawyer for 3 hours. Now, if you guys know lawyers, you know how much they charge.
Yes.
They provide 3 hours and some every month, free. And I rotate them. And they come and talk about legal structures and how you should protect yourself. At the end of that class, you think at least 5 people that I'm going to recommend to a lawyer anyway will get that person, right? So that's a win-win situation. The last class is the one I host. And I bring an accountant, because I told you I don't have accounting. So I bring an accountant to avoid problems, and I have them rotating, so I'm adding more to the rotation. So I have a different accountant that comes in every month, and he talks about tax exemptions, what you, how much you can expense, what you cannot admit, because people think you can go on vacation, it's a tax exemption, it's not. So he would tell you, know, my business, my friend from the IRS would tell you that it's not correct. So he comes and talks about that 3 hours for free, right? He donates that time to our nonprofit. And then, if my clients, which I'm already working one-on-one with after those classes, need an accountant, I will ask them, did you enjoy the presentation from X, Y, and Z? Yes, I think you should give them a call to help you with your business financials. Right, so that's how that connection is made. So that's what the pro volunteer is. And then you have the opportunity to become a member. If you're interested, there's so many things that people come to us for that we are not able to do in-house, that we can connect them to somebody that can. So that's when your specialties will come into play, and it's a free lead, right? All I ask is you be nice to our clients. Okay, so that was that. Any questions about this? No? So far, so good?
The
meetings, when are they?
Yeah.
Yes, so great question. So they're every month, and they're for the first 3 Tuesdays of the month. The first 3 Tuesdays of the month. And actually, this paper, I think it's the pink one. You may have a pink one. It says start out process. That gives you a little more information on the class. And it actually has the website. It may be pink or maybe yellow for you. We have different colors. Yes, so this one, this website right here, the sbdccolumbus.com under events, look for the class that's this start now. That's the class that has the three. Now this is fun, right? Because we do a class, the first day we have a sold out waiting list, 50 people. Then people learn what it takes to have your own business on the first class. So when the lawyer comes, we may have 40 people. We lost 10, so this is too much work for me. And then when the accounting comes, I was so scared what they said. I'm not coming to that. We have probably 30 people. So I'm letting you know, the first one is the best one to come to first. And then definitely come to the other ones, but you will see what I'm talking about. And I'm okay with that. I'm okay that if I talk today, and you're like, you know what, this is amazing. That was great. I'm not ready for that. That's good. I save you money and headache. I'm happy with that. But if you still have that fire, you're like, I want to do it. I want to grow. I know I can. Or my cousin, my friend, my sister wants to do this. I'll be happy to talk to them. Yeah, I will create an idea for you, but I will help you develop yours. Okay? Then the next thing, so if you take a look, I don't know what color you have because the colors change. It could be yellow, it could be orange, and it's the Small Business Development Center, some information on the college. It looks like this. So if you have that paper, so this is something, so in our center, we're one of the few centers in the country that have all of these different departments in one, or centers in one, at Columbus State. So I have a Latino center, I talked to you guys about that. I did a Latino work. The regular core SBDC center, we do that. But then we have a manufacturing center, right? So let's say that you have a product that you created that you want to sell here in the States and also overseas. It could be an app, it could be a software, it could be a purse, scarf, whatever it may be. Then we have a department that will help you with the prototypes and that plan on how to go from an idea to a full thing. And our counseling is free. So the counseling of these departments are free, just to let you know. Then the other one is like, let's say that you're doing really good in America. You're like, okay, you know what? I want to take it to my country. I want to take it to the Dominican Republic. I want to take it to France. We have an international trade center. We actually have taken customers to Mexico to do business there. So if you want to take this international, it could be a service idea. You have a definitely great plan, a ministry you want to take internationally. We're able to help you with that too. So all of these centers are at the Columbus State. So whatever part, like you can start with an idea here and then you grow. So we could be with you for one day, we could be with you for the rest of your career life. We've been in business for over 30 years. And we have customers that make $10,000 a year, $100,000 a year, $5 million a year. So it really depends on what your goals are and how big you want to grow. This is really your world. You create it, right? Any questions about the centers that we have? Very clear? Yes?
How do you guys navigate with international laws if one is trying to extend its services or its skills outside the United States?
So we have a director that works with international trade. Her name is Roberta. And she is the one that has traveled with some of our clients like Mexico. She has connections because that's her position with different countries. And then here in the US, we have the Department of International Trade. And actually, America loves exporting. They're not super excited about the importing, but they love exporting. So when you want to export something, they want to help. Sometimes there's some grants available for some of those processes. There's not a lot, but there's a little bit of money available to help you compensate when you're going overseas. But they will be able to help you with whatever country, like what the taxes are for that, how does that work there, what is the process for that country. There's a website with that information, and there's actually contacts for that, depending on what country you want to go. Okay, great question. Yes?
You have other world, and you have Latino Center. Are you thinking of expanding to other language settings?
Yeah, so the Latino Center is one that we're still expanding. Like some of our materials that you can see are on English. And even in the Latino, I am slowly translating a lot of that because I want to give the Latinos the same experience as the English. So we're almost taking it a language at a time because the Spanish one itself and on Latina is not fully where it needs to be. So we're hoping that like we give advice like the workers come, that other languages are included. So we're like developing a new website, we're developing new marketing material. So we're hoping that in that we can bring other languages because we have a multi-party in Ohio, we have so many different cultures. So we should represent that. But we're not yet where we want to be. A great question. Okay, and then this one, so how many of you have a business? Raise your hand. A ministry is the business, right? Yes, even if it's a nonprofit, it's still a business. Okay, how many of you have a register? Officially registered. How many of you have an accountant that helps you with your taxes for your business? Okay, a few less hands. How many of you have a lawyer that has done your articles of operation for your company to protect you? Perfect, less hands. So if you didn't raise your hands in any of this, we need to talk. I just want to make sure. That's like the test I do. So this page right here is with the state. And again, they give you some information on registering the business and because you should know about the industry and to start your business. So there's, I mean, we're literally, if you didn't know about us, you can do a lot of things online. You can. Definitely fine. And you can. But sometimes you need that help to kind of guide you through some of the things that are not available online. Like, I will call to stay with you, something is not clear. I'll be the first one to pick up the phone in our meeting and call to make sure things are what it's supposed to be. So you kind of have that coach, you know, with you that will help you grow your business. So that's what some of the things that we do at the SBDC. We're very busy, so when you make the classes, the first steps, so you say, okay, I learned a little bit, now what? So the first step to get the assistance that you need, I would say, is to attend the classes. Attend that BizStart class now, because even if you've been in business for 10 years, it's something that's gonna be very helpful to you, okay? And I've been in business for a long time with my father, and I still made him go through it. So it's a great class and a great opportunity to network. And then once you've done that, we do a small group. So we do homework. So depending on where you are, so let's say you've been in business for more than a year or two, and you're like, okay, I'm actually having this urgent need. We're not gonna make you go through the ropes of life to come to things you need to do. We'll be like, okay, let's address that issue. You need funding, let's address that. You have issues with an employee, let's address that. So we will help you with the things that you have an urgent need. If your urgent need is to grow and desperately you need your customers, then let's take a look at your message. Are you telling the people what really your job is doing, what your company can do for them? Because remember, people don't care about you. They care about what you can do for them. What problem can you solve for them? So your business card could be amazing. I am an A student. I love that. UI is not helping me, right? So those little things could be big. Yeah. Social media. I don't know how many of you have a social media account on Facebook. Only 4 or 5 of you. Facebook, Instagram, okay, Twitter. So for those of you that are not on social media, thank you for everybody that's responding.
You mean for the business or personal?
For the business. For the business. Yeah. So, but do you have personal? Thank you. What about personal? How many of you have a Facebook account personally? And it's okay if you don't. You're not a dinosaur. It's okay. So I asked that question for a couple of reasons. No matter what our business is, if you don't tell the people, they're not gonna know.
That's right.
Right? Don't expect them to knock on your door. You have to let people know what you do. I, in the beginning, people didn't know I did this, right? Because I thought my friends just should know. Like, you should just know what I told my friends. They're like, nobody knows. I'm like, oh, I should tell you. So you should tell them. And then your personal social media, it's not your therapy session. Right? And I tell this with the most humble heart. Because sometimes we want to share our feelings and what we're feeling because we want to be authentic. We can be authentic. That's what prayer is for. Be authentic in prayer. In the social media world, you have to be very careful because that's energy you're putting out, right? So when people want to do business with you, they're going to, even when we're hiring you now, they're looking at your social media. So why would people that want to do business with you are not going to look at your social media? They will. So be careful what you're posting. If you're having a bad day, your boyfriend, girlfriend, husband, boyfriend, whatever, your children, that is not the place to put it in. Right, so a few years ago, I made an intentional decision that my Facebook page was gonna be inspirational and informational. So if I was having a bad day, like my car broke down yesterday, nobody knew about that, okay? You know, a few things that happen, people just don't need to know that because there's so much negativity in the world already. And I watched an episode from Oprah that she talked about that, and I said, you know what, I have such a big influence in the world, and I didn't even know. Because social media is a new thing. It's new. We don't even know the problems that this will cause later in the future. We live in it right now. We're experimenting right now. So be, if you're gonna say something, be positive. Those of you that are ministers and men, and your pastors and you know, and your wife a pastor, like you have a beautiful influence to provide hope and guidance to the world. And in your business, whatever it is, if you can provide a tip of assistance and help to somebody, refer another business. That's a great way for you to get known as the person that likes to share and you know share opportunities, but then your job will be noticed, right? Your company will be noticed. So those are the things when it comes to social media personally, I need you to always remember before you post, I hope my words are in the back of your head. Don't post that. I have asked some of my clients take that down. I will call you. If you're my client, will become really close. And I will call you and I will task you to take that down. Because it is your job, your reputation that I care about, right? So those are the things. And then when you have a business, now Facebook is a little tricky now because a Facebook page doesn't get promotion unless you pay for it. So your personal page becomes your business page, actually. Because nobody's looking at your business page. Because that's Facebook is not, excuse me, promoting that. But they're promoting your personal page. Does that make sense? So if you didn't think about that, keep that in mind. And then later, we also have classes for Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. You can take those as you see need. But before you're ready to tell the world, let's get your message right, let's get your logo right, let's get your company right, your numbers right. So when you blow out, because once you do it really good and you share with the world, they're gonna want to do business with you. You need to be prepared to take that increase, right? So that's pretty much a lot of my presentation. I'm open for questions. If you have any questions, concerns, I can answer those. Then appointments. So if you want to know when can we meet, so we're going to probably meet individually after September 30th. Because the month of September is when we wrap up things. So we have classes and things. So I encourage you to attend those. But the scheduling of one-on-one is very limited in those months. So I would recommend that if you're making appointments and times, that you email me. If you leave me your business card and contact information, I will email you and I'll start putting you in the calendar after September 30th. Okay? Any other questions, concerns? Did I scare anybody? No? You're still happy to do your own thing?
You said for the first class on jets, you have a waiting list. Yeah. So what that means,
I would say today, if you can go to the September one, hopefully people, because sometimes people wait till the last minute to sign up.
For the first Tuesday of September?
Yes, yes. And then the numbers, so they usually are the first 3 Tuesdays of September from 4 p.m. to 7 p.m. Okay. However, we'll be in California for some training the second week of September, so that date may change a little bit. So just kind of take a look at the dates, because it will show you the first class is this day, second class is this day, third class is this day. And if for whatever reason you missed a class, because you couldn't do the lawyer one, sign up for the next series in October and take that one. Okay?
Do you advise that we come to only one of the sessions?
All three.
All three, yeah. Every month?
Well, just 1 month. Just 1 month. There's not month. There's 1 month, the same series repeats. So you just have to take it 1 month. So if September is not good for you, you're like, nope, I have my life plan in September. Then you can do October. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So don't go, I mean, you can go there every time, but I don't recommend that. Yes. Any yes?
Yeah, actually, this is not a question, but a suggestion. Since we are actually networking with one another, and thank God for our brother Tyler, who is actually presiding over this. If we can be able to have a list of all the dates that we have available, I believe on our sign-up sheet we have our emails there, and we have a mass email shootout to everyone that is present here, so people can look at their schedule and know which one that suits for them, and actually get in touch with you. So that will be able to serve every other one that is here. To be able to attend the class based on their scale.
Okay, so
that's a suggestion I do.
So you let me sure I understood that correctly. You wanted to send out the available dates for the classes?
Yeah, we will appreciate if you can have your schedule, like you said, after certain targets that are open, then pass that on to Tayo can shoot us a mass email on the dates that are available and we can pick it. It's based on our schedule.
Fantastic. Okay, so from my personal one-on-one with you.
Yes.
Yes, okay, I understood that. Thank you. I can do that with you if you like.
And again, if it's okay with everyone, I can forward that all the contacts that we get today, the email, contact it to her so she can just read it directly to
us.
Look at him. Look at him so much. I see you smart, Tyler. Great delegation there. Any other questions? Was this helpful?
Yes.
I hope I didn't scare you. It is always my intention. All right, so I'm going to bring you out.
Okay.
So thank you so much for your time. I wish you the best. Thank you. Thank you for your time.
go back to her seat. I want us to sing for her. She's a jolly good fellow.
She's a jolly good fellow. She's a jolly good fellow.
To sing, and my wife told me I'm a bad singer. I keep improving every day.
That's great.
I believe I'll get better with it. Thank you so much. You see, there are some things that are free in life that we are not aware of, that we are not taking advantage of. I met her not long ago. Even today is my first time of singing, or singing physically. We've just been talking on the phone. Thank you for the for coming. Thank you for everything that you're doing. Please, you still have a card. If you need a card to contact, that's one of the things. We want everybody to do to have your own business. You are not free until when you have your own business. Maybe that's my point. Free in, because it might not be in terms of financial, it might be in terms of time constraint. Somebody else is controlling your time. But once you have your own business, you'll be able to control your own time, which is a precious thing. Time is what nobody can, that you cannot give back. At this time, I want us to please stand up again. Let's network. Talk to someone you have not talked to before. Please, the guest speaker will be going around to pass that please, let's network again, especially people you've not talked to before. Let's put around. Please, let's do that for like 5 minutes.
Thank you for the time that you gave us. I'm saying 5 minutes. I'm going to ask you how long time you've decided.
5 minutes. Okay. Let's go around, let's talk.
Thank you.
Network. Tell them what you do.